Hi, everybody, and welcome to today's wonderful session on creating the pages of these little books that we made last time. This one is this little traveler's journal with the elastic band out here where you could add dangles and stuff if you wanted to. And then inside, I wanted to just show you some of the pages. So this is a little pocket, and I found a little cutout of a doggy. I think that was from Daphne's Diary. I don't know if you get that, but that's such a great little magazine. And then just some collage, a belly band with tags, a pocket with a funny little picture in it. So I'll show you how I've done all these little add-ins and tip-ins and stuff. And those of you who know Allie Manning, this is her beautiful business card. I just love it. Those are all books that she has stitched. And what else do I have here? Some of my painted papers. And yeah, because one day I spent much of the morning, I put black paint down on a whole bunch of book pages, and then I got out my white pen and gold pen and just doodled. And I have just so many fun little pieces from it now. So I highly recommend, if you don't know what to do, paint a page black and start doodling. It's wonderful fodder for collage and so on. Let's see. Some more paper. Paper bag, brown paper bag, and then a pocket. And this is a pocket too. I think I put little tags. I just stapled on a little piece of whatever paper I used. And then the second signature has some more collage stuff in it. Let me see if I can straighten that out a little. Another pocket. I wanted to leave some of these maps because I think they're really cool looking anyway, even if there's nothing else on them. Here's a tip-in. I'll show you how to do those. Another little envelope. Another pocket with some things stuck in it. And that's the end of that. And then it's closed with a piece of elastic with a button, and I will show you how to do that. Oops, I'll show you how to do that and not have it snap off. Okay, so for today, I'm using the book I made last week, and I have a whole bunch of papers and scraps and things like that, because this to me is what it's all about. When you're doing collage, this is the stuff that makes it really unique. So don't think that you need to throw anything away ever. And then I have some washi tapes. This is a small sampling. And then I have these little tins with stamps and what else? Stickers. Somehow I got a whole bunch of state stickers. I used to live in Rhode Island, so I chose that for the cover so I know what's inside. This just has little journaling cards or some kind of cards. I think they're Tim Holtz. And these are really funny. These are stickers, and some of them are based on the tarot, but they're funny. And then some are similar to the Loteria cards, the sort of Mexican bingo kind of thing. And if I can find where I got these, I will link it for you. And I could use Altoid tins for these, but I've run out. You can only eat so many Altoids. So these I got on Amazon. I think I got 5 or 6 in a pack, and they're the same size as Altoid. So I will put a link to where these came from. And then I just have scissors. I have a tape runner, and somewhere I have a glue stick here. I'm using my glue stick. Let's see, G-L-O-O. So really what I do is I just start somewhere. And very often, actually, I'm going to move this out of the way. There. Very often when I start, I literally will just glue down something. And it doesn't matter what it is, but you have to start somewhere, right? So I'm going to go over to my handy dandy tray full of fun stuff. And let's see. This is an old Montgomery Ward catalog page. Well, it's a reprint of a catalog page. So let's find something that will kind of fit on there. I like to tear stuff sometimes. So rather than having a nice sharp edge, this will give it a kind of fluffy or fuzzy edge. And sometimes that works really well in collaging. Here, you see, there's the hard edge and the fuzzy edge. So I'm going to do that on both sides. Some people use a ruler to do this. Let's see. So you would do it like that and just pull the paper towards the ruler. There. So then you have that. I want to put that on a bigger piece of paper there. And that. Okay. Now this is a Tombow tape runner. It has a little flap and that's the sticky stuff. So this is easy. I know glue sticks are easy too, but sometimes you don't even want the mess of a glue stick. And there you have it. There's a little page already that's begun. And then probably want to put something else on it. This is some kind of handmade paper. You might put that on it. If you start thinking about it, excuse me, too much, excuse me, it'll stop you. So that doesn't like, it's a glue stick for this part because the tape runner doesn't like this paper for some reason. Okay, let's put it down there. And find another page. I think I want to make a pocket. And when I do pockets, I like to use just sturdier. This is scrapbook paper. It's just a little sturdier than, you know, book paper. So I'll put it on the front cover. I could do it this way and have it tuck in there, or I can do it down at the bottom. I think I'll do that. And get my scissors, just cut it a little smaller than the page. A little smaller, like that, so the book can still close. And I'm going to make a little, I don't know, a thumb thing where you can then get what's inside. And I find the easiest way to do that is trace something that's round, but just trace half of it like that to make a half moon shape and cut that. Or if you have a round punch, you can use that and just put the paper in halfway. And so then you have this thumb hold, I guess is what it is. Like that. Let's see if the tape runner likes this paper. Maybe I'm doing it upside down. How about that? There we go. And the other thing is this will make this pocket a lot smaller because it already takes up, you know, what, an eighth of an inch or so. But that's okay. And just rub it on and then find something fun to put inside. There's a little card with the letter K. I think this must be from some sort of game. I don't know. I got a bunch of them somewhere. There. Pocket and a bit of collage and off we go. This was a paper I was playing around with stencils. So I'm going to leave that. And let's see what else. Oh, these postcards. I think the words will fit if I cut them out and then I can put the crown. I don't think it's going to fit on the whole paper. Maybe it will. Let's see. Well, let's cut it out and see. My daughter's in England right now, in London. She was born over there when she was 10. We moved back to the States, but she has all kinds of family and friends still over there. Let's see if this will work. Yes, I think that works just fine. Look at that. It's like a perfect fit. Okay. Try this again. If you've never used a tape runner, I I recommend you try it just because it's neat and clean and fast, and it usually stays stuck. Haven't had a problem yet. You never know, but I'll put that right there. Okay. And then I mentioned a tip-in, which some of you have seen me do these before, but these cards are, I don't remember where I got these either, but this says practice the encouraging life. And I think that might be the deck. The deck might be called that. Let's see if this one says it too. Yeah. Use your strengths to support success. But this one says community. You value the love, encouragement, and support you give and receive. And this really speaks to me about this clubhouse group. You know, I think those of you who have been coming to the live sessions, I hope you feel that sense of community. And when we change this over to the membership, which is going to happen sort of the end of this month, early September, that's what I'm going to be really working on, is creating that sense of community where you guys interact more with each other. And I also teach something that might be useful. So I'm going to put this near the front because that's, I just think that's an important message. Actually, I'll put it on this page. And when you flip it over, you'll see what's underneath. Now, when you do a tip-in, you have to kind of think, you have to think about which direction do you want your card to flip in, up, down, sideways. If it flips up, then you need to get two pieces of tape just a little smaller than the top. And if you do it on the side, you need to cut two pieces of tape smaller than the long side. And I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to do this, and it's going to be upside down there, but that's okay. I know, I'll put it this way, and I'll have it flip up. So find the tape you want to use. Let's see. It has to be wide enough to be able to sort of go on both sides. You know, I'll show you what I mean. If the tape is very sticky like this is, then you don't need to use a glue stick. But if it's not sticky enough, then put glue or some tape. And you're just going to put a little tiny bit on the front. If you're tipping it up, you put it on the short side. And if you're tipping it out sideways, you put it on this side. But you attach it, of course, from the back. And you want to leave a little hinge. Let's see if this helps. No. You want to leave a little space because this is a hinge. So you don't want it to be touching. Let's see if I can get in there and leave a little space. Let's see if you can see that. So then you need another piece to cover that sticky part. Again, smaller than the card itself. If the tape extended out to the sides, it wouldn't be that easy to flip it over. So that's just one little thing to think about. And that is called a tip in, a tip up, a tip something. And very often I will put something underneath it that will sort of be a surprise. I think a key would be relevant. The key to community, something like that. And I can't cut straight. That's okay. There. So then when you get to that page and you go, oh, I wonder what that's, oh, what's under there? And then you read the message and you see the key and hopefully it makes sense. Okay, moving on. We've done belly bands before, but if you haven't seen me do one, again, you need some stiffer paper. And a belly band is a pocket without a bottom, basically. And for this, I'm going to cut it smaller than this. I'm going to use my X-Acto blade to get it in just 2 inches, I think. Yeah. Okay. I've got my Olfa knife. I just like using this knife. It's always got a nice fresh blade if you need one. I don't need one because I just changed it. So for a belly band, I'm going to this other section here. And put it on this piece. Once again, you cut it just a little shorter than the page itself. And so the page is, 3.5? So this is going to just be a little less than 3.5. So one, 2, 3.5 is right there. So I'm going to do it in between the half and the quarter. See if that works. And it does. It looks so small, but it will fit. And a belly band, it doesn't have to be horizontal and it doesn't have to be a rectangle. You can cut it so that it is more interesting. Maybe I'll do that both ways. Like that. And then you just put glue or tape on both sides of it, not in the middle. I mean, not on the bottom, like you would for a pocket. And, oops, I don't want to stick it down. Before you know, it's on the paper there. And then I have a, what's this game called? Yeah. Put it in the chat if you know what this game is. Trivial Pursuit, thank you. That's what I was trying to think of. This might be too big now that I have that tape. No, it just fits. And the reason I use a belly band rather than a pocket is because I like to see as much of this card as I can. Sometimes it'll have something interesting on it. Why is it called a belly band? Oh, okay, now it sort of goes across the belly. A puppy pocket. There's all kinds of names for these things. Okay. Another collage page, I think, is in order. And I have this old ledger paper. This is literally from the 1890s, I think. So. Oh, and then like with any kind of book that you make, in the middle is the only real page you'll see the whole thing because everything else is the half page. So sometimes it's fun to find something that'll span that whole page horizontally. And I'm not seeing anything in here other than something going sideways, but I guess this woodwork. And then I can collage on top of this. Maybe I'll do it off center a little bit. I'm going to use my glue stick for this. Let me just do that on my scrap paper, which is over here. I'll be just putting glue on the back of this ledger paper. Oh, it's so fragile. Look at that. Okay, be careful. Put it down very carefully. Underneath the rubber band, if I can get my hand underneath there. Use your bone folder to just get that nice and smooth. Okay. So then that one will be able to move with the paper. Let me just get that corner. Okay. And then to collage something on top of that, maybe a little piece of map. Let's see, what is this? Let's see if I can get some of Alaska. No, sorry. Can't get Alaska in there, sorry. It's too far north. Well, we'll put that here. Okay. And if you don't have a bone folder, you know, you can use your fingers, you can use a credit card, a hotel room key, whatever you have. And this is one of those stickers that sort of mimics the tarot deck. And it's a little tricky sometimes get it to unstick itself. Somewhere, there we go. I'll just stick that down here. When I do collage, like I said, I don't think too much, but I do have a variety of things to choose from so that I'm not just limited. Because if I start getting limited, then I start thinking, oh, I wonder where that thing is or something like that. And I don't want to go there, but there I have all my little stamps. And I do like using postage stamps, even if I can't really tell which way is up on this one. I need my other glasses, hold on. Okay, here. I still don't know which way is up. There are people on Etsy who sell vintage postage stamps, and it looks like this one came from somebody who was collecting them. I don't like to interfere with the preciousness of these, because clearly I don't think there's many stamps left that are going to look like this. Let me put that there. And then I just want a bit of color down there. Let's see if I have any. Oh, some painted paper. Looks like that was fun. I think this is a roll off from doing jelly printing. Just sort of, roll it off on a piece of paper. So then we can use that for something. I think I will put it all the way across. So I'll need to just have a little more from this page. Under the band, and then some more. Yeah, that'll work. Again, if I were to think it through a little too much, I probably wouldn't use it, and I'll show you why in a second. because this doesn't match up. And if I were thinking too much, I would go, oh no, I need to find something that will match. But if I'm just doing this collage happily, intuitively, I don't really mind that it's not the same design right there. I think it just makes it more interesting somehow to have a collage that, you know, maybe doesn't make sense to somebody. I don't know. Okay. If there's any particular type of embellishment you'd like to see, please put it in the chat. Susan says Alaska is the biggest state, so that's why it doesn't fit. Right on, Susan. Okay. Otherwise, oh, I know. I have to show you how to do the elastic closure. That's important. Okay, let me get all this out of the way. And for this, you need a button and some elastic. Where did I put the elastic? Oh, goodness. So I just, oh, here, I'm going to use green. I just have a variety. Again, I got it either on Etsy or Amazon, just some elastic. Because once you start making closures for your books, you do use it. Oh, how do you do the paper sack pockets? Good question. Okay, let me find a little paper sack. I'm sure I have one somewhere. Hold on, I will find one. Okay, that's right, because I did show you that. Alrighty. Okay, so This was a paper sack. It was a little lunch bag. And I've already cut it up. However, I can create a sack that has a little gusset if I cut it to size. So let me do that. I'm just going to cut it a little shorter, line that up on this grid. And just slice it. I mean, you can make a paper bag pretty much out of anything. So now we have that. Let's put that on the inside of the second signature. And I'm going to put it, that'll open there, and this will be cut to size here. Essentially, you're doing a similar thing. Yeah, you're doing a similar thing to a pocket, only it's already its own pocket. I'm going to close this side up. I think I'll staple it. I don't want to lose too much space. So sometimes, or if you have a sewing machine, sometimes that's a really good way to, oops, come on. Now I want to do that same little thumb thing, but it needs to be probably, no, this will work. This will work. It's a good idea to do these before you staple it, but oh well, I didn't think of it till just now. And I'll need smaller scissors to get in there. I'm just sort of following that line, not too accurately. There. Okay, so that's a little paper sack. And I'll just glue that down. that. And then we can put something in it. Let's see. That won't fit, but that could be a tag. Make that into a little tag, but not right now. Let's put another one of these cards in. And actually what I might do is punch a hole and make that into a little tag. Does that explain it, Susan? Well enough, little paper bag. Okay. Okay, so the elastic button thing is the last thing we'll show you. And I get these little wooden buttons. Some of them are shaped like birds, but those won't fit the elastic. So these round buttons, that's what I used on the owl one. And because this is so many bright colors, I want to have a brightly colored button. So there, that's a pretty one. Okay. Put these away. And then you need a length of elastic that will be tight across the book, but not too tight. And that's the tricky part, is figuring out, well, how tight is too tight and how loose is too loose? Because this one clearly was too tight. And of course I lost that green last. Oh, here it is. Okay. So what I do is get it out of its little knot, first of all, and just find a piece that fits around comfortably without being tight. So that's really loose, and then cut some extra off. And then you're gonna feed the button through. Problem with sideways. Okay, I'll use this button. You're going to feed the button through from the back through to the front. And you might need a little pokey tool to help you with that, or tweezers or something that will help it. Here's some tweezers that will help poke it through the hole, because it's not going to want to go clearly. Let's see. And then it starts to fray, so that's always fun. You could get thinner elastic, and I do have some somewhere. I just don't know where I hid it. There. Now it's going. It's going. I'm going to do this off camera. It's too embarrassing to have to poke this through, have everybody watching. Let's see if I can get it. I should have used the smaller elastic here. Okay, I got that part through. Now I have to do it the other way. I have to go back down, cut this again. Maybe if I cut it at an angle, it'll go through easier. That seems to help. And okay, off camera again, sorry. It's really not this hard. It's just this elastic is much too thick for this button. I didn't have the problem last time, so I must have used a thinner elastic, I guess. Okay. Come on. You know, one of my favorite mantras in life is, inanimate objects do not get to win. So this elastic was not gonna win. I'm just saying. Now we take it, we put it around our book, and we start playing with tying it so that it's tight enough to hold it, but not too tight that it is really hard to get on and off. So let's see if this is good. There. Because I'm going to be filling this and I want it to get a little heavier, fatter. So that's good. Tighten it up. And then trim the ends. You might want to put a little dab of glue or something in that little knot. But there you have it. Nice little book band. Really easy to make these. I learned this from Allie Manning from Vintage Page Designs. And there's your little book. I hope you've enjoyed this. I will stop the recording now.